Sometimes they would place a sack over my head as I was continuously beaten.
Ra'ed is one of many Palestinians who have experienced excessive torture in Israeli prisons. Now, a new report reveals 90% of these prisoners being physically and mentally tortured by the Israeli Security Service are deprived from consulting with an attorney or their family before confessions are made.
In normal societies, prisoners meet their lawyers upon request, but in Israel, it's not the case. Israel has passed a law that says a prisoner cannot meet a lawyer for 6 months, which is also extendable for an additional 6 months.
The study produced by the Israeli Human Rights Organization, Public Committee Against Torture and Palestinian Prisoners Society, has found that during some periods when prisoners are being kept from meeting with their lawyers, Shin Bet begins its interrogation. The report cites these cases as an act of systematic violence and torture. Many of the Palestinian prisoners who have testified have claimed that the excessive torture and the psychological abuse were merely tools to get the prisoners to confess to crimes that they were accused of. Ironically enough, the Palestinian prisoners said they were granted a visit from the lawyer, but only after they agreed to confess to the crime. According to the study, these interrogations go against international and Israeli laws. Abdel Al was sentenced to life in prison for what he calls political reasons, but was liberated following the Oslo Accords in 1993.
Israel wants to break the will of Palestinians, but the Palestinian resistance is far stronger than that. When the Palestinian activists start the resistance, they know what may happen. Not one single Israeli prison guard can break us down.
Authors of the study have unfolded that between 70% and 90% of the detainees in the years 2005 to 2007 were forbidden to meet a lawyer in order to provide counsel and assistance prior to signing a confession. Rena Kamal, Press TV, Al-Quds.